Welcome to the iQ-Check Easy Extraction Deepwell Protocol. Here I am in the lab. This is the DNA negative area, DNA positive area. I've got my handy quick guide so I don't forget what to do next. Let's get started. First, we're going to pipette 100 microliters of the lysis reagent, which is on the stirrer. It has a stir bar inside to keep everything homogenized. Now, if you are working with something like listeria, for example, and you need grinding beads, you have to add those at this point. So let's add 100 microliters, keep the bottle on the stirrer. And for the sake of time, I'm just going to add a couple of wells. Now we're ready to add our sample. You'll notice I only have one in here, but imagine this tray is completely full. I'm going to open up the stomacher bag, and those samples been at 37 degrees for about 21 hours. Now I'm going to pipette out 100 microliters from each sample, kind of smush the bag to get the solution up to the top so the pipetta doesn't go in, just the tip. We're going to add that in, and let's imagine I have a second sample here. Take out 100 and add that into the next well. Okay. Now we've added the lysis reagent and the sample. The next thing to do is to cover. So let's start out. Put on the plate cover, and you can use the shiny side to smooth it down. Make sure there's no air bubbles. Now you pop it onto the agitator. We want to go for, let me check, handy protocol. We're going to do 95 to 100 degrees for 10 to 15 minutes at about 1300 RPM. Let's get this going. Now we can go over to the DNA negative area and create our PCR mix. So here we are in our DNA negative area. I've already changed my gloves and I've made up my PCR master mix with my probe and amplification mix using the table on the back of the quick guide. And I've remembered to include the positive and negative controls as well. So now I'm ready to add 45 microliters of our PCR mix to the plate. At this point, you want to be careful not to introduce any air. You can check in the pipette tip as you pull up the solution to make sure there's no air as you add it to the PCR plate. There we go, three added. Now we're going to take our positive and negative controls along with our PCR mix plate over to our DNA positive area. Okay, let's put our plate down and our positive and negative controls into the block. Grab our samples. Going to want to let this sit at 15 minutes on the bench or 10 minutes in the fridge. Let's pretend we've already done that. Now we're ready to transfer our sample into the PCR plate. Handy multi-channel pipette for this. You're going to want to use the side of the tip here as a guide so that you don't push the whole tip into the bottom of the well. So let's give this a try. We want to transfer 5 microliters. Push in the tips. There you can feel it. Now you're going to want to bring up your sample and pop it in. Last thing to do is to add your positive and negative controls to the plate. Now you can cover your plate with the optical caps. Plate goes into your machine. If you have a large volume of samples, you're going to want to use the CFX and hit run on your software. That's it. Come back and you have your results printed out so you can do some great data analysis and look for your positives and your negatives. Thanks for joining us. If you have any tips that you want to share, email us labnotes@bio-rad.com and please subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time.